Hello, welcome again. We are solving some questions of thermal engineering. The topic is IC engine, compressor and gas turbine. Question number 3 is, choose the correct statement. Option A, between same temperature limit, Carnot cycle, Erickson cycle and Stirling cycle have same efficiency. Option B, between same temperature limit, regenerative Erickson cycle and Stirling cycle have same efficiency as that of Carnot cycle. Option C, between same temperature limit, Carnot cycle, Britton cycle and Stirling cycle have the same efficiency. Option D, between same temperature limits, regenerative Britton cycle and Stirling cycle have the same efficiency as that of Carnot cycle. Okay. So this is your Carnot cycle, and here the temperature, heat rejected at constant temperature and heat is rejected at constant temperature, and in between there are two isomers. Okay. And this is your Stirling cycle with constant volume, two constant volume processes, and heat addition and heat rejection at constant temperature. So here the all the heat rejected is supplied to this process, one two process. Okay. So it means there is no heat rejection overall between in this process, because Q1 is equal to Q2 and the heat rejected from in process 3-4 is supplied to the fluid or substance between 1 and 2 process. Okay. So that is called regenerative Stirling cycle. Similarly, there is Erickson cycle also, and in the Erickson cycle there are two constant temperature processes, and all the heat rejected during constant pressure process is supplied to this process. So overall there is no heat rejection during the process. So these two processes combinedly become adiabatic processes. So these are, so this constitute your Carnot cycle. Okay. So and efficiency of Carnot cycle is 1 minus T2 by T1. Okay. So answer is option B, between same temperature limit, regenerative Erickson cycle and Stirling cycle have same efficiency as that of Carnot cycle. So option B is the right answer. Next question, 4 to 6, the minimum temperature and minimum pressure and temperature in Otto cycle are 100 kPa and 27 degrees Celsius. The amount of heat added to the air per cycle is 1500 kilojoule per kilogram. The compression ratio for the cycle is 8:1. Take CV is equal to 0.72 kilojoule per kilogram per Kelvin, and CP by CV is equal to 1.4. Then question number 4, the maximum temperature in the cycle is option A 2610 Kelvin, option B 2211 Kelvin, option C 2773.13 Kelvin, option D 1815 Kelvin. Work done is 588 kilojoule per kilogram and 847 kilojoule per kilogram and 711 kilojoule per kilogram and 600 kilojoule per kilogram. Thermal efficiency of cycle is 53.1%, 49.8%, 56.8%, 5% and 60.1%. Okay. So the pressure is 100 kPa. Initial pressure is 100 kPa. Okay. And so P1 is 100 kPa and the cycle is Otto cycle. Okay. So this pressure is 100 kPa and temperature is 27 plus 273, 300 Kelvin. Okay, so heat added is 1500 kilojoules. So that is heat added during process 2-3. Okay. And because in Otto cycle the heat is added during constant volume process. Okay. And the compression ratio is given as 8:8. So the volume V1 by V2 is your 8. So CV is your 0.72 kilojoules per kilogram per degree Kelvin. actually per day becoming, and gamma is 1.4. Okay. Now for process 1-2, as the process 1-2 is isentropic process or adiabatic process, reversible adiabatic process, so T2 by T1 is equal to V1 by V2 gamma minus 1, and V1 by V2 is 8, so this is 1.4 minus 1, so T2 by T1 is 8.4 or 300 into 2.297 or 689.1 Kelvin. Okay, so T2 will be your 689.1 Kelvin. Okay, and also in this process P2 can also be found out by because P1 is known by using that P1 V1 gamma is equal to P2 V2 gamma. So P2 by P1 is V1 by V2 raised power to gamma, and V1 by V2 is 8, so it is 1.4, and P2 by P1 is 8 1.4, so the ratio is 18.379, and P2 is as P1 is 1 bar. Okay, as P1 is 1 bar. Okay, so P2 is your 18.379 into 1, that is 18.7379 bar. Okay, so next process is constant volume process, and the heat addition during this process is that is 1500 kilojoule per kilogram. So heat addition during this process CV is T3 minus T2 is equal to 1500. Okay, and CV is your 0.72. Okay, and T3 minus and T2 we have found out, that is 689. So from this we can find out T3. So T3 will be your 2772.1 Kelvin. So answer to question number 4 is C. Okay. And now once this T3 has been found out, then we can find out the pressure also by using state equation, because this is a constant volume process. So P2 V2 by T2 it should be equal to P3 V3 by T3, and V2 is equal to V3, so P2 will be equal to, so P2 by T2 will be equal to P3 by T3, so P3 is equal to P2 T3 by T3, sorry, P2 T3 by T2, and so we can find out because we have P2, we have T3, and we have T2, so we can find out P3 is just 73.94 bar. Okay, so next process in this is again adiabatic process, which is expansion process. Okay, so during this expansion process where we have T3 by T4 is equal to V4 by V3, that is gamma minus, or the power gamma minus 1, and V4 by V3 is this is your V4 and this is V3, and V4 by V3 is again gamma, because these are the constant volume processes. Okay, so the ratio of so V1 is equal to V4 and V2 is equal to V3. So as V1 by V2 is 8, so V4 by V3 will be 8. So by putting the value of V1 by V2 as 8 or R as 8, we have T3 by T4, and we have calculated T3 here. So we can find out T4 also. Okay, so T4 is 1206.9. Okay, so that is the that ratio is the T4 temperature is 1206, but the maximum temperature is your T3. Okay, so T3 is your 2772.1. Okay, and the specific work done is, as work is done during the two adiabatic processes, this is your expansion process, this is compression process, so we will find out the work in these two processes and subtract. So CV T3 minus T2 minus CV T4 minus T1, CV T3 minus T2 and CV T4 minus T1. Okay, so if we take common CV as our 0.72, so T3 will be your we have all the temperatures, we have T3, we have T2, we have T4, we have T1, so by this we can find out what that is, 847 kilojoule per kilogram. And next is thermal efficiency. Thermal efficiency is nothing but work done by thermal plate, and work done is we have calculated 847. Okay, and heat supply is CV T3.